Hello, good evening. Welcome to .programming.blogspot.com. This is my blog. Today I will show you how to use Java static variable, that is part 2 of the static variable. In this tutorial I will discuss about the more about the static variable. Okay, so write something into your notebook, static variable part 2, or you can say the static keyword part 2. We all know about the static keywords, because in my previous video tutorials I will show the static variable is used for memory management and memory sharing. In this video tutorial I will show you static variable. We are talking about static methods. Yeah, okay, previous video tutorials contain the static variable, that value preserved during the program execution. What is the method of the what is the meaning of the static method? That method call, first of all, because in a Java a main method is also static. So when we call any class, that method execute firstly. So by the static method we can change the value of static variable. If you want to change the value of the static variable, then you can use the static method. No need to create an object for that to call the static methods directly, that call from the class name. So no need to create object for call static method. Directly call from class name. Okay, now come to the third part. What about a static method? There is no need to create object for call static method. So this and super keywords here. This is a keyword and super is also a keyword, so this and super keyword not allowed in a static method. Let's take a simple example of static method. Now open first of all change the IDE here is my editor. Class student, integer roll number, static string college name, because college name is the common for all the students, so the college name is BITS, BITS, Birla Institute of the Training and Institute. Technology and Science. Here we have a method that is static. According to my previous slide, there is no need to call static method for an object. So there is no need for to create a object to call static methods. They are directly called from the class name. So simply you can say that this is not overloaded. So college underscore name is Sanford. The first point is clear. The static variable change inside in static method. Okay. Now call a constructor int r roll number is r. Public void display to print the value of the roll number and the college name for the students. So system.out.println roll number plus college name. Constructor for initialization data members. Okay, so now come to the main methods. That class over in the last section. Yeah, so now come to the another class. So to create another class which takes a main method, class main public static void main, one string argument. Now first to call that change method by using the class name, because there is no need to create an object for the static method that is change. So directly call from the class name student.change. Now the college name will be changed from Bits to Sanford. If you want to initialize the roll number for the students, then must to create a object for the students. So student S1, new students. Here we have a single student that call that constructor. So S1 dot display the whole information display by that method, and that method called from the object of the class. Okay, so output comes from that. The last will be the roll number is 123 and the college name is Sanford. Okay. You can check by using your NetBean ID, or you can also check by using any editor. So thank you very much for watching this video tutorial. Please keep watching my all other video tutorials which is related to Java. In this session I will show you the same example which is written in the notebook, and you will get the same output which is already shown in the notebook. Okay, so please subscribe my channel if you like it, and learn many more things about Java. So again I tell you thank you very much. Please watch the full video tutorial for your output and better understanding.